Hi, hello, welcome back to my channel and welcome to another video. Today I want to share with you my experience with co-living. So I'm going to be walking you through what it is, how it's structured, some of the things it offers, and then who can benefit from it. So I want to give you a full overview in today's video. I spent my first 14 months in New York City living within a co-living community. So I know some of the ins and outs, but I want to simply share with you my experience and what I learned along the way so that you can make an informed decision going forward if this is something that would be right for you. I'm ready to jump right into it, so let's first talk about what co-living is. It is essentially as it sounds. You are living with other people. Easy enough, right? If you've ever lived in a dorm situation and have had random roommates, that's basically what it is, just for full-fledged adults with traditional jobs instead of school. Co-living is something that is currently gaining a lot of popularity because of the perceived benefits that it offers. So it's very cost effective. It offers furnished spaces, which makes it really easy for you to try out a new city without having to commit to it long term. And most of them have really great amenities as well, such as cleaning services and community events and things of that nature, which we are going to be diving into all of this later in the video as well. Like I said, it is becoming quite popular, especially in the United States and especially amongst millennials. And it's important to note that there are different setups of co-living situations. So there's such thing as informal shared housing, communes, cooperative housing or co-ops, and then co-living companies, which is what I personally experienced. Some of them you may have heard of include Bungalow, Dwell, Common, Outpost Club, and We Live. So with all of that being said, let's jump into how co-living communities are structured. All right, so an important thing to talk about with co-living is how it is structured. It's a little different than traditional living. So of course you're going to have your monthly rent price. You're also though going to have a membership that is built into your rent. So this kind of tripped me up at first when I first heard about it. It's kind of weird, but it is factored into your rent. It's not an additional expense or anything. Your membership fee covers things such as the weekly cleanings that you get, the amenities of the building, the community events that are sponsored by whatever co-living company you're with. So be aware that that is something that is factored into your rent price, and it does make the price go up a little bit. That's why some of these prices may seem a little bit ridiculous, in my humble opinion, but some real numbers for you. So for my one bedroom in a four bedroom apartment in Brooklyn, New York, which if you're not from here, Brooklyn is typically considered the cheaper borough. For my one spot in a four bedroom apartment in Brooklyn, New York, I started out by paying $1,675 a month. This was contingent on a 12-month minimum lease, so they did have shorter leases, but that made the price go up, obviously. I actually ended up living in two buildings in my time with Common. So when I moved from Wisconsin to New York originally, the first building I signed on was sight unseen, meaning I reserved my apartment spot and my apartment while I was still living in Wisconsin. So I had a place to move into. Didn't see it, didn't know really the area, wasn't familiar with Brooklyn at the time. And so that was the room that cost $1,675 every month. Once I moved in, I realized it was not in a good area and it was a fairly shitty building too. So I requested a transfer, which we're gonna talk about transfers in a little bit. That is another perk of co-living situations, specifically with Common. I requested that transfer and transfer just, I think, 2 months after I moved in. Second building I lived in was so much nicer. The apartment was a lot newer, a lot more updated, and it was more of an apartment feel. The first one was more of like a dorm type feel. The second apartment was also slightly cheaper in rent. So my rent went down from $1,675 every month to $1,650. So saved 25 bucks a month on rent by moving. So that was great. I'm gonna wait till the end to discuss this price more and we can
have a discussion around whether that price is worth it or not. But for now, I just wanted to give you the hard numbers so you can get a sense for what you're looking at if you're looking to move to a big metropolis like New York City with a co-living company.
Wanted to take a second to pop in here and let you guys know that we are so close to 100 subscribers, and I am really excited about that. So I will be doing a 100 subscriber giveaway once we surpass that milestone. So anyone who subscribes to my channel will have the opportunity to be entered into that challenge. You'll learn more about it once we hit that milestone. I'm gonna make a whole video about it, but now would be a good time to go ahead and hit the subscribe button below to join our community so that you can be a part of that giveaway. I'm really, really excited about it, and I do want to just give a big thank you to everyone who has subscribed to my channel up until this point. I love you guys so much, and it means the world to me that you've taken your time to subscribe to my videos, subscribe to me. It shows me that you care about what I have to say, and that means the world. So I just wanted to pop in here, let you know that's coming. Let's get back into the video.
Moving on from cost, I want to talk about the physical space, like the actual room, the buildings, all that jazz, because that's just as important, right? So with your rent and membership, one of, in my opinion, the biggest perks of co-living is that you get a fully furnished apartment. You do not need to worry about paying for furniture. You don't need to worry about movers or any of that. Your apartment comes with a couch, a living area set up, you know, all the appliances, utensils, whatever. Your bedroom comes fully furnished with a bed and a mattress and dressers and nightstands, lamps, you know, whatever you need, it's in there. They make sure of that. Also, an important thing to note, the units in New York City are air conditioned. So you don't have to pay for an air conditioner. You don't have to pay extra for, you know, anything like that. That's another thing I don't think I included in my notes here, but all of your utilities are included with your price. You do not have to pay for internet. You don't have to pay for air. You don't have to pay for electricity or water or anything. All of that is bundled into your base rent price. So that is a major perk in my opinion. Yeah, it's factored into the rent price. So, you know, it's not like you're saving money on it. It's just they take care of it for you. But the fact that you don't have to set any of that up or do any of that is really nice. So all you need to bring with you is your clothes. And that goes back to me mentioning why this has become such a popular thing, especially with millennials. You know, I don't know about you, but I know for me personally, I'm in this headspace where I like to just go explore and live new places and get out there. And I think that's really common with our generation. We don't want to stay stuck in the same town for 40 years and, you know, all of that, like a lot of our parents did. And if that's true for you, if you want to stay in your hometown, by all means do. I'm not shading that in any regard. I've just found that with a lot of other millennials that I know, it's pretty common that we're wanting to get out and about and see the world, essentially. And so co-living makes that really easy to do. All right, so going back to me briefly mentioning the transfer thing, this is another very cool perk of co-living. I'm gonna specifically be talking about common here because that is the only true hands-on experience I have with this. Common has buildings all throughout the United States. In New York specifically, they have 26 buildings. With your membership, you can transfer to any of their other buildings, whether it's within the same city. You can, you know, come live in New York for 2 months and then transfer to San Francisco for a month or two. And then maybe you want to go live in Chicago for a while. You can do that, and they make it really easy to do. This is dependent on availability though. As far as I know, there's not usually much vacancy. However, they do give priority to people who are already renting with them. So say for example, you come in and want to rent at the same place that someone brand new wants to rent at. They're going to give priority to you since you are already an active member, you're already paying your rent, you already have your membership. You're gonna get chosen over the new person. So just something to take into consideration. It is dependent on availability, but it is a really cool perk nonetheless. Finally, as far as structure goes, I want to talk about amenities. Another big thing, right? We talked about the membership that you are paying for. And with that, you have such thing as community events. So these are events that Common sponsors for you and you can go to for free. Some of the cool ones I remember, just to give some examples, I went to Madame Tussauds in New York City here, the Wax Figure Museum. They had tickets to the Museum of Ice Cream. I signed up once to go to a concert. I think it was like a Wiz Khalifa concert. They were giving out tickets for that. Really cool. They often did tickets to like Yankees and Mets games, things of that nature, pizza making classes, wine and paint nights, like all sorts of stuff. However, these events were on a first come, first serve basis, and they did have a limited number of spots available for each. So for the big ones, you were only allowed to go to one every quarter, so one every 3 months, and in that, they only had like 3 or 4 tickets available, so you really had to be on it to go check their community platform. They had an app, they also had a website where you could go log in and like get your tickets and whatever. But still really cool that they provided these opportunities to go have fun, get to know some of the people you're living with, whatnot. I had some really fun experiences doing this. I also had some really awkward experiences. So I can make a whole separate video on some of my stories living at Common. I'd be more than happy to do that. I have a whole roster full of them. You could also host your own parties, you know, either for your building or for anyone to come attend at your building or in your unit and whatnot. And Common would usually go ahead and provide dinner gift cards or alcoholic beverages or things of that nature. You just had to let them know you were doing this and then get like X amount of people to sign up for it. So that was really cool as well. They did offer weekly cleanings as a big amenity. So you would have a housekeeper come in every week and clean the common shared areas, such as the kitchen, the bathrooms, living room, all of that. So they'd vacuum, they'd sweep, they'd dust, they'd put the dishes in the dishwasher, scrub off any surfaces, what have you. This was really great during COVID, especially. You just knew your apartment was being professionally cleaned, which was really nice. Kind of piggybacking off of that, toiletries are included with your membership. So Common provides the common goods, such as toilet paper, paper towels, sponges, trash bags, dish detergent, laundry detergent, all of that sort of stuff. When I moved in, they were even offering shared coffee and olive oil and things like that. But the longer I lived there, the more their shared supplies and what they were offering dwindled down. But nevertheless, they did offer that, and during your weekly cleaning, your supplies would be restocked. Lots of things to think about when considering the structure of co-living and whether or not it's right for you. But the main ones I think you should keep in mind are the cost, how the physical space is set up, and then the amenities that are included with your rent and your membership.
Lastly, before I let you go, I want to talk about who may benefit from a co-living situation. I would say that if you are someone who is moving to a big metropolis like New York City, Los Angeles, Chicago, like a really big city where cost of living is quite expensive, and you don't know anyone, maybe you're moving internationally or from somewhere across the country and you just don't have connections in this city, that's when I think co-living would be a great option for you. When you look at the co-living situation from a bird's eye view, you know, $1,650 a month in rent for one bedroom within a 4-bedroom apartment kind of seems like a ripoff. You know, if we're thinking about that as a whole, that's around $8,000 for a 4-bedroom small apartment in Brooklyn. Like, that's unheard of. You could get a really, really nice apartment with the same square footage in Manhattan for that price, like a luxury apartment. So when you think of it that way, it's not worth it. However, if you think about it in terms of individually, you know, you're going in, you don't have the connections to go and lease an apartment with like friends or family or something like that. You don't have your network of people within the city. That's when I think that $1,650 makes a lot more sense, because yeah, it's technically still a ripoff for 1-bedroom and a 4-bedroom apartment, but you're also paying for the community that comes along with it. And that's something that these co-living situations really push, is their sense of community. And on that same note, if you are moving to one of these big metropolises by yourself and don't have anyone to live with, you're not going to be able to find something for yourself, like a studio or a 1-bedroom, that's going to come in under that $1,650 price. Maybe you could, but it's gonna be kind of sketchy, probably in a not so great area. You're not gonna have nearly the amenities you would with a co-living space like this. It's not gonna be furnished. You're not gonna have cleaning services. You're not gonna have in-unit laundry, what have you. So that's where you kind of have to compare the two. Again, you're paying for the community as well. So just from my own personal experience, some of the best friends I've made in New York came from Common. The second apartment I lived at with Common in Brooklyn here, I got along so well with our roommates and we had so much fun. We would spend holidays together. We would go out and party on New Year's Eve. We did fun things, like me and one of my roommates, who's now just a really close friend of mine, went to an Ariana Grande concert together, and we would take advantage of the community perks that Common offers and just do fun things together. And so I made a really good group of connections and made some friends. And honestly, some of my best memories from New York City came from Common. And so I think it's really great if you're going to a new place by yourself and just want an entirely new experience. That's who I would recommend it for. All in all, I would say my experience with a co-living company was neutral. There were good things about it. There were also not so great things about it, which I didn't really dive into in this video, but if you're interested, let me know in the comments and I'd love to make a follow-up to this video as well. Overall though, I think it balanced itself out and it gave me some really cool experiences and some connections that I hold near and dear to my heart. With that being said, you guys, thank you so much for watching today. You know I love when you watch my videos, so thank you. If you did enjoy this one, please be sure to give it a like and go ahead and subscribe to my channel for more related content. I post every Wednesday and Sunday at 1 o'clock Eastern, so you can look forward to my videos at that time. With all of that being said, thank you again for watching, and I will see you in my next one. Bye!